My name is Miss Janelle, and I am so excited that I get to do an experiment with you this week. But has anybody seen Zoe anywhere? She was supposed to be here to help me, and I just haven't been able to find her. Oh, there you are, Zoe.
Hey, Miss Janelle.
What's the matter?
Nothing. I'm just a little blue is all.
Oh, blue.
Well, not to say that I'm actually blue. Technically, I'm green. I mean to say that I'm sad. That's all.
Oh, well, why are you sad?
Well, I was eating some ice cream. Chocolate chip. My favorite kind. And I took one lick of it off the cone, and then it fell.
Oh,
all
no.
The way to the ground, and it was gone. So now I don't even get any ice cream.
Oh, yeah, that is tough. You know, Zoe, it's hard when things don't go our way, and it's hard when we feel sad. Hey kids, did you know that when others feel sad, there's something that we can do? It's called giving comfort.
Comfort?
Yeah, comfort is helping someone feel better, helping to cheer them up. And Jesus wants us to comfort others because God comforts us.
My precious ice cream cone.
Oh, Zoe, I'm sorry that you're sad. Hey, let's do our experiment together because I think it's going to bring you comfort because it has to do with bubbles.
Bubbles?
Yeah, bubbles are always a great way to comfort others. They make everyone so happy.
I like bubbles.
Yeah, and it's true that you can't make someone be happy, but you can be there for them when they are feeling sad and help them to feel better.
Well, that's nice.
Yeah, God does that with us because He is always with us. And He gives us peace, and He reminds us that He would never leave us alone.
Oh, and I do like bubbles, Miss Janelle.
Well, great. All right, that's even better that you like them. We're going to make some glow bubbles today.
Huh? Glow bubbles? Are we going to color the bubbles in midair with the Sharpie?
Nope, but you can watch and find out what we're going to do. Oh. So we're going to take this highlighter. We're going to take some bubbles, some Dawn dish soap, some glycerin, and a black light, and that's what's going to help it glow. And most importantly, Zoe, do you know what else we need?
We need an adult's help.
That's right. Okay, we're going to open this highlighter, which is an adult's job, and we're going to put it in this container of water right here. There it goes. And now we're going to add some bubbles. So we're gonna fill this up about halfway with bubbles because I already have about half of it with water.
Yeah.
So we're gonna add the bubbles just like that. All right. And then we're gonna take some dish soap, fill this up. You need about 3 teaspoons of dish soap.
3 teaspoons?
Yeah, so there's one.
But we're not gonna be eating it.
No, that would be yucky. There's 2. One more. And 3. All right, I'm gonna stir this up just a little bit because it all went to the bottom. And then we're gonna take some glycerin and we're gonna add about 3 teaspoons of that too, Zoe. So here's 1.
What does glycerin taste like?
I don't think it would taste very good. It's kind of like a really thick oil. Yeah. That would not taste very yummy. Okay, I'm gonna give it a good stir.
Oh, Miss Janelle, is it time to blow the bubbles now?
It is, Zoe. Okay, we're gonna get out our black light here.
Yeah.
I'm gonna turn it on and I'm gonna dip our bubble
wand
into our bubbles.
The bubble solution is already glowing.
It is already glowing, you're right. Okay, are you ready? I'm gonna blow the bubbles.
I'm ready.
Did you see them glow?
For a little bit.
Yeah, let me get some more on there.
Oh, well, thanks, Miss Janelle. Hey, those bubbles were pretty cool.
They were, weren't they?
Oh, yeah. You're right, I do feel better. And the bubbles were nice, but I think the thing that gave me the most comfort that whole time was you.
Aw.
You took the time to hang out with me when I was feeling sad. And that means a lot.
Yeah, Zoe, I'm so glad that you're feeling a bit better. Hey kids, we're gonna learn about comfort in our Bible story today. So put on your listening ears because it's coming up next. Hey Zoe, you know what? I have some ice cream at my house. How about you come over and we share some?
Oh, that sounds amazing!
Yeah.
Oh, goodbye kids!
Bye!
Oh, let's go, Mr. Now!
All right, let's go.
Ice cream!
Yay!
Ice cream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream!
The story before the story.
Today we're in the book of 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians is one of the 21 letters in the New Testament. The leaders of the early church wanted to teach Jesus followers what was true, and they often wrote letters to do that.
The Apostle Paul sent several of these letters to the believers in the church at Corinth. Paul had visited Corinth on his second missionary journey to tell people about Jesus.
Later, Paul learned that some people were speaking against him. There were divisions in the Corinthian church.
Paul wrote a letter to encourage them to get along and stay strong through hard times.
Which is where our story starts.
Take it away.
Hey everyone, I'm Erica. During his ministry, the Apostle Paul traveled to dozens of towns and cities. People who like to do the math think Paul probably walked 10,000 miles during his journeys. You heard that right? 10,000! And you thought hiking 2 miles with your family was rough. But even though Paul visited so many places and started so many churches, he didn't forget the people he met, like the believers in the Corinthian church. Paul had spent more than a year in Corinth, and when he heard there was trouble among the Jesus followers, he sat down immediately to write them a letter.
May God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ give you grace and peace.
Now, some Corinthian leaders were saying Paul wasn't really led by God's Spirit. They said Paul had faced so much trouble, it had proved that God wasn't really with Paul. What? You can bet Paul had some strong things to say about that.
Give praise to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. He is the Father who gives tender love. All comfort comes from Him. He comforts us in all our troubles. Now we can comfort others when they are in trouble. We ourselves receive comfort from God.
Paul couldn't wait to set the record straight. God is always with us, no matter what we're going through. And God is the source of all comfort. We're going to take a look at 3 words from these verses. First up, troubles. We live in a broken world, and every single one of us experiences hard times. Maybe some kids at school have been saying mean things about you, or you're really struggling with reading, or maybe your pet guinea pig didn't make it. Truth is, we can't escape trouble right now. Jesus told his friends, "In this world, you will have trouble, but be encouraged. I have won the battle over the world." This brings us to our second word, comfort. All comfort comes from God. We can first take comfort in knowing that in the end, God will make everything right. But let's be real. When you've just scraped your knee or had a fight with your brother, sometimes it's hard to think about the big picture. So, what does comfort look like? Well, you can start by remembering that God is with you, no matter what's going on, and ask for help.
God, this really, really hurts. Please help me.
Sometimes, God will simply give you a sense of peace in the middle of it all. But often, God comforts us through other people.
I'm sorry you got hurt. It's gonna be okay.
We'll get you something to put on that right away.
And here's the awesome thing. Just like God can work through other people to comfort you, God can use you to comfort others. As Paul told us, God comforts us in all our troubles. Now we can comfort others when they're in trouble. Not only is God with us in difficult times, but what we go through is not wasted. When we receive comfort, we learn how to give it to others. Comfort can look like a lot of things. You can comfort someone with your words.
I'm really sorry that kid was mean to you.
You can comfort someone by offering help.
I'm gonna get us a snack and then I'll help you tell Mom about it.
And sometimes the best way to comfort someone is simply by being present with them, even if you aren't sure what to say or do. God doesn't promise that all our troubles will go away as soon as we ask. But God does promise to be with us and comfort us in the middle of hard situations. And once we've received comfort from God, then we have the amazing opportunity to see what others need and offer help, compassion, and comfort. The end.
Let your light shine so others can see it. Then they will see the good things you do, and they will bring the glory to your Father who is in heaven. Matthew 5:16.
Change and it starts with me.
One hand high.